This is Charles Munoz talking about battery power for the Red Rover astrobotic vehicle. So you were just telling me about the unique challenges of operating a battery-powered vehicle on the moon. It has to do with the day-night cycle, right?
So between the lunar day and the lunar night, we have a massive temperature swing. It goes from being near the boiling point of water during the day, about 100 degrees centigrade, to near the freezing point of nitrogen at night, between negative 160, negative 180, depending on where you are. So if you want to design a system that can survive multiple lunar cycles, then you need something that's going to be able to stay cool during the day, but also survive getting cold at the night. Now, for us, we aren't able to keep the rover warm. Previous missions that NASA or the Russians would use an isotope generator, which would keep you warm, but that's not an option for us, so we have to design everything to get cold and then go into a hibernation mode with no power, no nothing, and then come back with the sun. So what we did is we found these cells. They use a lithium iron phosphate. It's a type of lithium ion battery. These are commercially available. You can find them in high quality drill battery packs. But we were able to use these and run a massive testing program on them to freeze them, and we determined that you could freeze these very quickly and keep them cold for a long period of time down at those liquid nitrogen temperatures, down at negative 180 degrees Celsius. And once you warm them up, they would perform exactly as well as they did prior to the freezing.
The key is a non-aqueous electrolyte, right?
Yes, the key is a non-aqueous electrolyte. So most batteries, they have some form of water in their electrolyte, and when water freezes, it expands, and that damages the cell with multiple chilling and thawing cycles. With these, that's not the case. When they get cold, the chemicals inside come out of solution, they crystallize, but once they warm up, everything goes back to exactly the way it was. You don't lose any power during the freezing, and they're good as new over multiple thermal cycles.
And just hold up that battery pack, the carbon fiber battery pack.
So for our purposes, we put them in a battery pack like this. This holds 9 cells in series, and it creates a pack that's about 28 volts or so. And we'll use 4 of these in our rover. Now, there's a couple of beautiful things about the design of this pack. One, it's very light, has a very good packing density. This is about 1 kilogram, which is considerably less than if we were taking, say, sealed lead acid batteries with the same power. Also, this is made out of a carbon fiber shell, so it's very thermally conductive. It's designed so that it will evenly take heat that's generated by the cells during daylight operation and move it around the shell to exit where it's interfaced with an I-beam on the inside of our rover, which would look like this. And so this is bolted onto the side of it, and the heat will come out of the batteries through this pack and then up the I-beam and out a radiator into black space. And that'll keep us cool during the day.
That's great. Thank you.